cataloging for many of our satellite libraries, including Clark Field Archive, and also here at the Language Learning Center, catalog videos. I am here today to tell you about a tool that has been in development for the past couple of years and that we've known about here at UNM for the past couple of years. And we've been wondering when would be the right time to present it. And now is as good a time as any. So let me tell you a little bit about the Berkeley Language Library of Foreign Language Film Clips. This is the main page that you will see when you first type in the URL. And I have the URL right there under the title of my outline. It is indeed a tagged structured collection of clips from foreign language films. And I think it's important to emphasize that what is being tagged and clipped are foreign language feature films, not documentaries, not TV shows, but feature films. At the moment, it is intended for the use of instructors as a tool for teaching class through these clips, through teaching your language through these clips. There is a process that instructors can use to, once they clip the film, they can publish it through the website and then order it for 14 days and present the clip to students along with tags and notes about the clip that the instructor provides. That is the way students have access to this. And at the moment, that is about it. The folks at Berkeley, I've been back and forth with the folks at Berkeley. They're thinking about making it more available as it is over there. But at the moment, that's not the case. So of course, the clips must be used within fair use. That is to say, we have to own the film. Did you have a question, Pam? I'm sorry, I saw your hand go up.
Oh, no, sorry.
Okay. I'm sorry, you, please raise questions at any time. I will try to answer them. And I can show you right here after I log in, but a summary of the fair use would be that you and I must hold the film. That is to say, we can't order clips from films we don't have. And after the film is ordered and after an instructor decides to tag the film, they can't tag more than 20% of it. So if a film is about 100 minutes long and they tag and clip 3 to 5 minute clips, about 7 to 8 clips can be made per film. And as I said before, it is limited to foreign language feature films. So I'm going to log in as myself. Should have done this sooner, I apologize for that. But I did want to show you the main homepage. Let's see if I did this correctly. Sorry, I'm not quite used to Macs. These are the terms of use. It is quite clear on the terms of use that it is limited to instructors. It is that this tool is intended for instructors' use. And that students will have access to clips that instructors have tagged with notes for a period of 14 days, and they will have access to only the clip. And of course, you know, as I said before, no more than 20% of the film, and it must be a film that we own. So let me log in and we'll get to the meat of the matter here. I did provide a link to the Fair Use Guidelines as well as a link to apply for an account. The folks at Berkeley have to, I don't want to say approve you, but they have to approve you. Make sure that you're not a student, that you are a instructor or a graduate instructor.
How do you know? Chris, there was a question. How did they know?
How did they know? Well, they knew that I was not a student when I applied for an account.
I just applied online and it makes you put in like the URL of your department. And so presumably they'll like go and do some phishing and make sure that like you're on the web page. There's even like a phone number you have to put in so they can't find you. Maybe they'll call or something.
Okay.
That's, I'm guessing, I don't really know how they decide. Maybe somebody just lazy and like, fine, approved. That was...
Right. Could be.
No, I'm an admin. Instructors will have different abilities than I do, and as it turns out, I really don't have all that many abilities. Instructors have, the way that the website is set up, it's a lot easier for instructors to locate a film and clip it, make note and annotate it, and make it available to the library, after which they will order it and make it available to students. But anyway, what I have to show you here is the overview section, and at the moment it consists of a way to send email to admins, to other instructors, from an admin to an instructor, from an instructor to an admin, such and so. The real meat of the matter is here in the collection. Now, I'm an admin, so I can add films to the collection. And the way that that's done is I can show films in various languages that are not in my collection. Sorted by English title. It's a little bit easier for me to use our cataloging database if it's in the English title. And truly, it goes in alphabetical order. And these are films that are not in our collection. And there are, looks like just about 2,000. But I can show films that are in our collection. Also, and we have 157. Now these are films that are feature films that are in the Language Learning Center video collection currently. It was brought to my attention that maybe the folks at Fine Arts would like to have them Spanish and Portuguese language videos put in here. that would be nice. I would certainly like that, and certainly I believe the instructors would like that and the students. But we're not there yet. I don't know if it's a matter of asking for forgiveness rather than permission, but that's something that has yet to be approached to the folks at Fine Arts.
I think all you really need is the list of the films. Because UNM owns them.
That's easy enough to get through WMS, our cataloging system. and then I can use this searching tool here to search our collection against the films that are not in the clip library and make them available. So there would be many Spanish and Portuguese titles. Let's go down to, for example, Portuguese. They're not in my collection. So what about English title? Oh, darn it. At the moment, there are six, so that'll be pretty easy to populate once we get the list. This could be a good tool for collection development. to get videos that the clip library has but we don't. And there are many. And there are many languages available of films that are in the Berkeley Clip Library. So now let me go to the next section, which is tagging. And this is the part of the database here that will allow you to locate films that you would like to clip. Clip them and then publish them. That is to say, make it available to order later on. And that process is as follows. Let me find a French film that are available for tagging, and I'll choose English. So here's A Heart in Winter. At the moment, it's not tagged. It gives you a little overview of the film, and if I wanted to tag it, I would have to claim it first. So let me go ahead and do that. Come on. And then it says from added to your stuff. So which stuff is that? Let me go back to the previous page if it'll let me. So there's the film that I claim. Now at this point, I can I can see that there are no clips that have been created for this film. But I can cut clips for it. And then it somewhere down here. Is play. And this will actually let me play the film. So in the interest of time, I'll move forward a little bit.
J'avais jamais vu en société, mais je l'ai trouvé très déplaisant, très désagréable.
Écoutez, c'est un jeu, vous
connaissez. See, this is a part that I really like.
Vous avez bien compris qu'il s'amuse.
Évidemment, c'est votre ami. Vous le défendez.
Je ne cherche pas à le défendre. Je l'accepte comme il est.
So right now I'm at 117.30. I'm sorry, on the left it says elapsed time, and on the right it says time left. That is a, my understanding is that that is an aspect of fair use.
Okay.
That the clip length must be limited to less than 5 minutes.
Okay, so not 20% of the total running time then?
You can have as many clips as you like, as long as it's less than 20%.
Gotcha.
But each clip is limited under 5 minutes.
Yes. Now, I can go back to tagging. Oops. Back to tagging, please. Okay, there's the clip that I made, the 1 minute clip. I don't know why I keep doing that, but believe it or not, I'm very good with computers, but I'm not very literate with Macs. So even after you claim the film and clip the clip, you won't be able to do anything with it for 24 hours. The folks at Berkeley have to process it. And then once it's processed, you can tag it with annotations and publish it. Now, of course, the clip that I just made won't be ready quite yet, but let's pretend that it is. I'm going to move this first. And right now it says there are no French clips that are ready. That's because I just made it and it needs 24 hours. But for example, this is one film that is ready. And you can see there are fields for annotations. There's a description of the clip. You can add vocabulary words, which is nice. English descriptors, How you plan to use it as an instructor? So there we are. I feel like I've been going through the outline and following the outline and following the film clip library, you know, step by step, but I'm feeling like I may have missed something. Does anybody have any questions or points of clarification? Yes, Heather.
I've got a bunch of questions. And I know you went over this, but okay, so let's say we have the clip, and then here it is, but then how do we share this clip with students, for instance? Like, can we put this on Learn, or do we have to go over it in class because only the instructor has access?
I will show you. Let's go back to the home page. Yeah, so this is not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for. So you don't have to use HTTP. Let's go where it says apply for an account. And in this section here, if it'll let me highlight it, it says that you intend to use the site for personal browsing, using, and ordering of clips. And then at the end, the only public display of film clips will be through the URLs provided when I order a clip. So after you order the clip, you'll get a URL. You can provide that URL to students, and they'll have the clip. And they'll have it for up to 14 days.
Great. Will that URL then include like the vocabulary and these kinds of descriptors, or is it only until the back end?
Whatever you provide when you created the clip, or other, you know, there are plenty of other clips available that have already been made.
Can you show us the one that I showed you? Can you go back to where you were and like show us how? You found the clip that you want,
mm-hmm.
or you found the movie that you want. Then how do you like? Find, see all the clips for it, and then how do you, is the URL just, it's just the URL when you click on that movie, on that clip, that's the URL for the clip, or what? They have to send you a URL?
You have to order it, and then they'll send you the URL. What I'm showing you is sort of the admin module of the film library. Sad to say, and this is something I discovered not too long ago, I don't have instructor privileges as an admin.
So that's something we need to explore,
mm-hmm.
how somebody who has instructor privileges.
Yeah.
Do you have them?
No, I had admin.
You have admin also. Does anybody here have it? You don't have it.
Does anybody here have a student?
So, Chris, I have one question.
That you can see, yes, Big Chuck.
After 24 hours in the Berkeley, they send you the URL for student to viewing that you post that published clip.
Mm-hmm.
And that clip, that URL, is it multiple user or is there any limit? Because how many students can access that at the same time?
My understanding is that it's
unlimited.
The entire class can have access to that URL, and we'll be able to look at that clip at their leisure.
So again, there is no limited of concurrent user.
Right.
Okay. There I am, by the way. Can you approve me?
I'm sorry?
Under the new user application? Like, are you able to approve me?
Let me see.
That's great.
Oh, so we can apply.
Yeah,
you can approve.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, let's say about it.
Oh, yeah. So another question, it seems like we're able to then see like what other instructors have used then across the nation, or people have used this, because we can go into a clip and then see other clips that people have taken from it, right?
Right.
Yeah, you don't actually have to tag any clips at all. That's something that volunteers do. It'd be nice if someone from this university did it, since we're part of this whole thing, but you don't have to. You can just use the clips that are already there.
Right.
And I think that's what we're trying to do to get the Foreign Languages Department instructors
I can tell you my opinion of that is that as a librarian, as a cataloger, I don't think I would have the same insight as an instructor as to what to clip, and certainly how to annotate it.
Yeah, so let's say I'm searching this site and I see something that another person has done, but it's not in our collection. Would I then ask the librarians to acquire this film for us?
Or me.
Or you? Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes, and that is the, how can I say it? I would see that as a good use of the collection tool. You can simply search for videos that we don't have.
Mm-hmm.
And then the instructor will initiate the process to order the film. And then once it's ordered, I'll put it in the collection. I'll put it in the film clip library so that it can be manipulated. So going back to Pam's question, I have not forgotten. I'm going to return this to the pool because I use that as an example. These are available films to tag. These films have not been tagged yet. These films, where it says clips to publish, they have been tagged, but they're not fully in the system yet. And we can look at the collection and look at all films in all languages that are in our collection.
Look, do Arabic films, just because Heather's an Arabic professor. So
let's... Okay, let's see how many Arabic films we have. I remember cataloging a few, and thank you very much, that was very challenging. Yeah, we have 9 Arabic films. And for example, Captain Abu Rayad already has 50 clips.
Is there any way to see any of the clips right now? Or you have to subscribe to them and get the URLs?
My understanding is that instructors can do that.
I see.
But
we can't.
Yeah, it looks like I can only search the University of New Mexico collection, like I can't search other collections.
No, I know when I took the tutorial, when Pam first told me about it about 2 years ago, that you can actually look at the tutorial and see how they behave. But I've actually, you know, it's just like a show and tell. It says, you know, here are the clips, you can use it in class, but then I didn't go beyond that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see. There's like lesson plans too that you can look at, but nobody's done one for Arabic, not surprisingly. That's great. But yeah, it'd be nice to be able to, I don't know if this is even possible. Oh, no, wait a second. Here we go. Browse films. Aha, I got it.
There, you get it.
Okay, I can't go to search. I have to go to films. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's why I was only 15.
Right, and this would be the interface that an instructor would have.
Great, oh, and this is lovely. So I'm looking at, another one of my questions was whether or not there are subtitles, but it looks like, you know, the cataloger tells us this, which is lovely. Okay, my other question I have is, can we get only one clip at a time, or is it possible to match clips together from different movies all into one URL?
That's a really good question. I imagine you can.
Okay.
You know, the fair use restriction is per film.
So I'm envisioning, like, you know, for beginning students, you know, just have people learning how to greet each other, just having, you know, a clip of different people greeting each other from different movies or something.
Mm-hmm. That's a great idea. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a limit to that.
Okay.
Once your 2 weeks are up, can you renew it, or can you just, like, do it again, or the same clips, if you want to have the same clips available all semester?
I imagine you can. Let me go back to the sign in page. And it's under apply for an account, but I left you the link in my outline. I'm looking to see if there's any kind of user limitations. Clinton says clips may be ordered for a 14-day period. 2 weeks from the date the clips are ordered, they will be made inaccessible. Now I'm reading that and thinking that you have 14 days and that's it. But you can, it does say you can make a request for an exception.
Yeah, I can't imagine they would say, like, you can never order this clip again. So we're going to use it next year for the students or something. You know?
No, I think what they're trying to do is just so that you're adhere to your curriculum so that, you know, on a weekly basis or whatever, not for the whole semester. But, yeah, I mean, I'm sure you can use clips, okay, request them again, or just write to Mark, who is the guy who runs this,
that's
and
right.
Ask him. He probably will let you have more access.
It was Mark Heiser. He and I went back and
no.
Oh, that's for email.
Okay, hold on, Chris. Les is coming.
I'm coming. Oh, you got it? Okay.
Got it.
All right.
So it provides a direct link to email him directly.
Okay. Okay, what if we know a film that isn't in this list? Can we request that it be put into this database?
Once we possess it, absolutely.
Okay.
Now who scans the film? I mean, if the film's not in there, we buy it. We say, at this film, do we have to send the file?
Let me show you how that's done.
How do they get the digitized version of the film?
Well, they have it in there. They have the films.
I see.
Already in the database, and so you look through and say, oh, we have this film.
Okay, and then
so
you tag
I'm going to add this to
right.
my collection. I don't know about...
If it's not in their database.
If I don't know about that. That's a good question, right. Sarah. I don't remember.
So if you look at the films that are in the master collection, or specifically not in my collection,
uh-huh.
go.
I guess that's it. You'll be aware of that.
Yeah, there you go.
Add to your collection. So
and then once we have a film, it's just a simple matter of me clicking that. And then from that point on, we can manipulate it.
So language teachers who want a film can ask me, I will order the film. Chris catalogs our films. So when he catalogs the films, then he can add them to the collection, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what I will do.
Yeah, and we'll definitely work with fine arts and just get their foreign language films. You know, I'm sure they have some Arabic films as well. And we can go by language, we can start with that. Because if they're in the fine arts collection, they're already cataloged.
Right.
So then we just add them.
Mm-hmm. And it's just a simple matter, truly, of putting that link.
Mm-hmm.
And it's added to the library.
That's great. There are some documentaries in here, still only under Arabic. I don't know how they snuck in there.
Well, I see 12 Angry Men is an American movie, so that's English.
Right.
Yeah, so it's feature films, right?
It's not like film strips made for language classes. It's
yep.
Yeah, so then they're getting...
So English is one of the choices. And then go.
Yeah.
And they have 366
yeah.
English films in the database. Some of them are ours, some of them are not.
Chris, do you know how, say you want to find films where they're, what you're looking for are greetings. Have you been able to explore enough to know how to find film clips, say Arabic film clips that have readings?
Like, yeah, if you can search by the
tag. I think there is a way to, yeah, to do that.
Uh-huh.
What I did was I went up to, after I logged in, I went up to I want to go back to where it says LFC Home, and then search.
The descriptions are all in Arabic, like they're not in, uh-huh. really in, the in English, I'm
yeah.
sorry, not in whatever tar-
oh,
language it is. So like all the descriptions for whatever reason are in English, which is good, I think, because it makes it easier to search
right.
rather than to let things sort of slip by you if you're just forced to use English.
Okay, so toward your example of Buenos Dias, I used Bonjour. And there are 33 films where Bonjour is somewhere in the title description, pedagogy tags, and or comments.
Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, because it's
yeah, that's it. That's a part of my French movie.
Sure,
one word
or two.
Thanks, one.
Well,
those
give me two. Good day and
hello.
Good
day. So let's try again with
this. This is really great because some of these movies have subtitles in Arabic, which almost never happens.
Oddly
enough.
You know, you can also look online, on our website where we have that link,
mm-hmm.
and you can search for Arabic subtitles in all our collections, too. Because that's in the description.
Chris, do you know that in the search box, can you search the original languages, or just English?
In this search box?
Yeah.
You
have to search all in English. You cannot search like, Japanese or Chinese or Korean. It has to be romanized, huh?
Yeah, I'm afraid it does.
Yeah, it doesn't have that capacity for different languages.
So when it comes to the subtitles, I mean, this is something I can play with later on, but I mean, do you have the option to choose the subtitles you want if you like know English subtitles to force the students to listen, or you know, that kind of thing, or is it just everybody who has the URL then chooses their own subtitles?
Are you talking about the subtitles that are part of the film?
Yeah, exactly. Some of these have, there's more than one option. There's either none English or Arabic, for instance, in this one that I'm looking at. So they can't have all three at the same time, obviously, but yeah, so I guess when you make the clip, maybe you request the subtitles.
Yeah, I see what you mean. I suppose that's something that
let's look at a clip that has different subtitles in it.
Yeah. You want to know? Let's look at a film. No, I don't want an English film.
Oh yeah, I can't watch movies we don't have, which makes sense.
Right.
Oh yeah, you're right.
So I can request purchase though on the, that's nice.
This is all 3 minutes. But we're never good for English films.
Oh yes, okay. It does look like it has like the subtitles option. Looking at clips here, but I mean, I guess it's hard to know because whether like the URL that we get sent from Berkeley is gonna match exactly what I'm seeing on here. Something to play around with.
Yeah, one would think it would, since that's what you asked for.
Yeah.
How am I doing on time?
We have 3 minutes left.
Three?
Yeah.
All right.
Sorry,
I kind
of monopolized all the questions.
That's okay.
That's okay, Heather. I'm really, really glad you asked them. You know, as an administrator, like I said before, there's only a limited amount of things I can do.
Mm-hmm. So maybe, Heather, after you play around with it, you can do another presentation. Because we don't
from
have...
From an instructor point of view.
Yeah, it'd be nice to hear from one of the things
Yeah, it's great because like people who have published clips already that I can see, like, can go to the clips and like how other teachers have used them, and that's really nice because then it's good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the ones that that UNM owns.
But if UNM don't own, can you view them?
No, but I can request them.
You can.
So whether or not you may be getting a barrage of requests coming up here.
And then this is the way to submit a film request. For films that we don't have, and that it is Berkeley.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's how you do it. Okay.
So that's where it is. Yeah.
That's under help.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm wondering about that. Because I think we do have some films, Chris, that aren't in the master collection.
That wouldn't surprise me. You know, go back to admin here and try to show you. That there are a little less than 2,200 films in the Berkeley collection.
Right. But like we have a lot of Arabic films actually, and I think if I remember correctly when I was going through this, I remember that we had some that they did not have.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That would make sense because there's only like I think. 7 films on here in the collection of Arabic.
Yeah.
And I know you guys have more than 7 films.
Right. So can anyone make that request, or does it have to be an administrator?
I believe an instructor can make the request. By going to this section of the film club library, choosing help, and then in the drop down menu, request film out of the master collection. So they have to do it at Berkeley. You know, we can initiate it, but. Mm-hmm.
It looks like I can request here.
I'm really, really grateful that you came. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.